idea, even according to the official statistics, the standard of living, official, fell down by 40%.
即使根据官方统计数据，就是生活的指标也下降，只是下跌了40%。
And then the tragedy began.
然后悲剧当然就开始了。
Because Yugoslavia was a multi-ethnic state of different republics.
因为南斯拉夫是一个多民族的共和国。
And local communist parties in each republic.
每个共和国的当地的那个共产党呢？
In order to remain popular, to legitimize their rule, started to play the nationalist card.
为了合法化他们自己的统治，他们就开始这个用这个民族主义来。
Their message to the population was, "We will protect you from other republics."
他们向那个大众传播的消息就是，我们会把你们从其他共和国那里保护，我们会保护你们，反对其他共和国。
The lesson from this is a very important one today.
这个教训对我们很重要。
You know, when you hear about ethnic tensions exploding,
当你们听到那个种族冲突爆发的时候，
don't take it too literally. Look also for other reasons.
别把它不要只看字面上的意义，然后从其他的方面来观察它。
I claim that in X.Yugoslavia, ethnic tensions exploded because of the economic crisis and because of the, let us to use Habermas's term, legitimacy problems of the communist nomenclatura.
他想说的就是说在南斯拉夫解体以后，种族危机之所以爆发，是因为经济危机的问题，也是因为那个共产党这个共产党的领导这个统治官员希望来合法化自己，这个合法性的问题。
I'm always deeply distrustful of those specialists who say, in order to understand what happens in this country, you have to know 1,000 years of history and so on.
我非常不相信那些所谓的专家，尤其是他们说为了了解一个国家，必须了解他那个几千年的历史之类的话。
I think, of course, every country has 1,000 years of history, but that history is usually selectively awakened to serve the present needs.
当然，每个国家可能都有上千年的历史，可是这些历史都是被有选择性的提取出来，来服务当下的。
So, but even in your country, you had an effect of this chicken.Who shouldn't know.
就是在中国也有这种鸡不应该知道的这种现象。
I read, maybe it's false and sorry, but I read that in the time of the hunger that you have after the Great Leap Forward.
在大跃进以后的那个饥荒时代。
Oh my God, okay. Sorry. That Mao Zedong wanted to see how people really live.
毛泽东想看看大家生活到底怎么样。
And that he took the train from Beijing to Shanghai.
他就坐火车从北京去上海。
But that, so the local cadre knew that the train can stop at any point and Mao will inspect the nearby villages.
但是各地的干部就知道他在哪停，去看什么村庄。
So, the way I read is that in a tremendous effort of work,All the villages in this long line near the railroad, you know, the buildings were quickly painted, people were better fed, and so on the idea that if Mao may stop there.
所以呢，就是他读的这个书就说，比如沿线的这些村庄就把房子给油漆了，然后又把人民就给老百姓吃得更好一点。就是如果毛泽东去看的话，能看到。
But so that.You will not only think that I'm making fun of politicians.
我这里并不仅仅是在嘲笑政客。
There are also very dignified, tragic examples of chicken who shouldn't know.
他们其实也是非常有尊严的悲剧性的那个不知道的鸡。
Isn't it that often, for example, if, and this is quite dignified, nothing comic about it, if a father in a family learns that he has cancer.
就是如果在一个家庭中，一个父亲知道他得了癌症以后
，He tries to cover it as much as possible, especially from his children.
他也不希望他的那个家人知道，尤其是他的孩子。
In order not to make the situation for them too difficult.
就希望就是这个情况对他们来说不会太困难，不会太受折磨。
Of course, here the situation is often much more tragic, but in a beautiful way.
这个情况往往是更加悲剧性的，但是呢，这个悲剧性的方式可能是更加美丽的，或者说。
Usually the child knows that the father is ill.
就是美好的，通常说就是这个孩子其实是知道父亲是有病的。
But pretends that he knows nothing, not to hurt the father.
但假装不知道，因此呢就不会去伤害这个父亲。
So, I'm not making fun of appearances.
我并不是在取笑表象。
My attitude is not appearances are deceitful, we should always tell the truth.
我的态度并不是说表象永远是欺骗性的，我们必须要深入才能够找到真实，不是这样。
At some level of everyday politeness, we have to follow the appearances.
在每天的日常生活的这个礼节这个层次，我们必须遵循这个表面的东西。
For example, I don't know how it is in your language, but in English, when I meet a friend, I usually tell him, oh, nice to see you, how are you? But we both know that usually, hey, I would prefer to avoid you.
通常呢，这个说这个话的意思就是：第一，我其实想避开你，想躲开。
And that, I don't really care at all.How are you?
而且我也根本不在意你到底怎么样，不管你是好还是不好。
But nonetheless, it's wrong to say that this kind of exchange is hypocrisy.
但如果我们说这种交换是虚伪的话 ，hypocrisy 虚伪的话，那也不对。